All right, so we're doing a voiceover. So yeah, guys, in this video, we're gonna cover a shoulder workout with some triceps. One thing I wanna note here is that I was 1 week out from a show when we filmed this. So although I am lean, the weights are not going to be heavy. So we're starting with a incline rear delt dumbbell fly. So you'll notice a few things on this one. I really let my shoulders slouch over the bench. This is not an exercise you want to have a big chest on, because if you do, then you're going to use more traps and rhomboids. So you kind of want to let your shoulders slouch over the bench to make sure you're engaged in your rear delts. And it's going to feel like the range of motion isn't huge, which is exactly how it should feel. And you shouldn't be able to use a whole lot of weight. And I would really, really recommend you do high reps when you train rear delts. I've always found that rear delts, it's easier to isolate them under lightweight. They shouldn't be able to move a ton of weight by themselves if you're trying to isolate them. So yeah, lightweight, high reps with the rear delts. Okay, so from the rear delt flies, we're moving on to dumbbell shoulder press. So now that the shoulders are warmed up from doing the rear delt flies, everything's nice and loose and ready to go for some heavier presses. So on this one here, I did go a little bit heavier. After I got my warm-up set done, I just moved on to the 100-pound dumbbells and only went for sets of like 8 to 10. I think I might have got one set of 10 here and the rest were just sets of 8. So, like I said, being 1 week out from a show, typically I would go higher reps on these, but I just wanted to get some good weight on my shoulders. I was just kind of feeling it that day a little bit. With the shoulder press, I just try to keep the weight like as far back close to my ears as possible, so that I am working the anterior delt, but I am getting some medial delt involved in there a little bit too. And you guys will also notice that when I do my sets, I'm only doing about 3/4 range of motion. So the idea behind that for me is just to keep all the tension on my anterior delts and my shoulders. The top of that movement there is gonna be, if you lock it out, is gonna just be your tricep finishing the exercise. So I kind of just wanted to save my triceps for after the workout and just get as much out of the presses for my shoulders as possible. So just a 3/4 range of motion on these. And then on to dumbbell lateral raises. So there should be at least one lateral movement in any shoulder program, just to isolate the medial head of the deltoid. So, you know, when we train that with high reps and good volume, we want our shoulders obviously to grow. We want the width. So the wider your shoulders are, the more it's going to accentuate like the smaller waist look. And then if you have the quads coming out too, it's going to give you the X frame. So in bodybuilding, like that's the desired look. So lots and lots of lateral raises, lots of volume. We did a couple drop sets for our last couple sets here. And then usually I'll even do another lateral raise movement to finish the workout. So then it was on to wide grip upright rows. So instead of doing another lateral raise movement, I did this for my second exercise for my medial delt. So right from the lateral raises into the upright rows. So they were already pre-exhausted, so that's why I like going straight from the lateral raise to the upright row, because I do incorporate a little bit of traps and biceps obviously on getting that weight up there. But with having the wide grip, I really do try to focus on dragging the weight up with my shoulders and my medial delts. So just another one. And at the top too, also, you'll notice that I have a big chest and I pull my shoulders back. And at the top of the movement, I also try to squeeze my rear delts as well as my medial delts. So it's almost in a way like a compound isolation type movement for the medial delt and rear delts. to completely finish off the medial delts. We did some cable side laterals. So you'll notice how I use the actual cable system to grip onto to sort of lean away from the machine. So this just gives me a more desired range of motion to keep all the tension on my medial delt. I really just try to bring the handle down to my hip and no further. I don't want to cross over my body because then my rotator cuff, my trap, are going to actually take over that first part of the movement. So I just let the medial delt do its job and just almost, again, like another three-quarter range of motion from my hip just right up to the right up to shoulder height. So from there we go to the cable front raises. On this exercise I try to keep a really tight core just to keep my body English out of it as much as possible. The cable's going between my legs, so I just try to really focus on using my anterior deltoids to bring the weight up. Again, just like another range of motion just to finish off the anterior delts. They were pretty worn down from the presses, but you know, that's why we use the cable. We just focus on that one little muscle that we're trying to work and just absolutely kill it. So we did four or five sets here, drop set at the end for the last set, and then we go on to the triceps. To start off triceps, we just went with a straight bar cable push down, so just a tricep extension. My first couple sets went really light just to warm up, get the elbows warmed up, get some blood in the triceps before we do anything heavy. That's just to avoid injury purposes, to avoid getting elbow tendonitis by, you know, starting off with super heavy weight. So idea here, just get as much blood as we can in the tricep, and then we move on to machine dips, which we went a little heavier on. Really like this plate loaded hammer strength machine for triceps. It's also good for chest. It just depends on your body position, but because we're trying to do triceps, I sit as upright as I possibly can. So when on the eccentric part of the movement, I'm just trying to let my triceps stretch at the top, and this machine really does a good job because it forces your elbows behind your back so far. If you don't have one of these machines, you can just do regular dips like on an assisted dip machine or even bodyweight dips. Again, just focus on your body position and staying as upright as you can. And then on the way down on the concentric part, just push and lock it out and squeeze the triceps at the bottom. Crazy pump from this one. Even though being super low carb on a week out, I got a lot out of this movement on this day. So another great movement for triceps. Make sure you go heavy on these ones. And even though biceps weren't on the menu for this day, I had a great pump in my triceps, so I knew the blood was there. And you know, being for a week out from a show, you know, doing a bit of extra arms isn't gonna hurt anything. So we just threw in three sets of seated bicep curls at the end, just to move a bit more blood around. So overall, it's a great workout. Hope you guys enjoyed this video and got something out of it. Stay tuned to the Jack Factory YouTube channel for more. We got tons and tons of content coming. So if you haven't, subscribe. And please like this video. Thanks, guys.